A warm good morning to all of you students. Myself Samuel Prabhakar, principal of Python Public School. Back live on your online classes. Children, I hope you are fit and fine at home by the grace of God. These educational videos are really proving to be very helpful to you in this quarantine period. These educational videos are prepared by your faculty so that you can have a virtual class experience at your home, and you can experience this class, share this classroom experience by simply sitting at home. Your teachers are working hard for you, and the only thing that you can do for them is just focus on these videos, take these videos seriously, and reply to these videos. Okay? If you have any kind of problems regarding to these videos, if you are not understanding, then definitely discuss these problems with your teachers on the Telegram account. Our mission regarding to this quarantine period only will be successful if you cooperate with us. So, without wasting time, let's move to our third episode of Pronouns. Students, in the previous two episodes, we had discussed about pronouns. Children who have missed that videos can again view those videos. This episode is a combined episode for students of standard 6, 7 and 8. Because pronouns is a common chapter for all these three standards. So students, pause this video and take out your English Splendid Highlight grammar books and take out the chapter Pronouns. Children, in the previous chapter we had discussed about pronouns. Again children, I am going through a quick summary of those previous chapter. In the previous video, we had learned about the definition of pronouns and we had learned about their kinds. Like we had learned about what are antecedent. We had learned about personal pronouns and their group. We had learned about demonstrative pronouns. We had learned about demonstrative pronouns. In the previous two videos, we had discussed about all these corresponding groups. We had learned about the definition of pronoun. We had learned about antecedent. We had learned about personal pronouns and their groups. We had learned about possessive pronouns. We had learned about demonstrative pronouns. And we had learned about interrogative pronouns. Today, we will learn about, we will carry on with the other kinds of pronouns. This is the last episode of this chapter because today I am completing this chapter. Students who have missed the previous two episodes can go through this episode so that you can get a detailed content through these two regarding two videos. You can get a detailed content regarding these groups. Okay, let's continue with the remaining kinds of pronouns. The next group of pronouns that we are going to learn, children, is reflexive pronouns. reflexive pronouns. Well, hard to pronounce. Children, don't be frightened by these complicated words, because after explanation you can understand. Okay? So don't go for the massive pronunciation of these words. After explanation you will feel it very simple. So what are reflexive pronouns? Reflexive pronouns are those pronouns which refer back to the subject. Okay, the reflexive pronouns are those pronouns which refer back to the subject. Now, first I am giving you some examples so that you can easily understand what are reflexive pronouns like. Just go through these three examples. The first example, I will solve this problem myself. Now, just focus on the definition. Once again, I am reading out the definition. Reflexive pronouns are those pronouns which refer back to the subject. That means, which again relate back to the subject. Now, what is the subject here? I. And the word myself is referring back to the subject. That means, I will solve this problem myself. यानी, मैं इस समस्या का समाधान खुद करूंगा. He can finish this work by himself. Now, what is the subject here? He. And what is the reflexive pronoun that is relating to the subject or referring back to the subject? That is himself. Okay? That means, he can finish this work by himself. वो ये कार्य खुद से खत्म कर सकता है. रितु विल मेक अ केक फॉर हरसेल्फ. व्हाट इज द सब्जेक्ट हियर? रितु. एंड व्हाट इज द प्रोनाउन व्हिच इज रेफरिंग बैक टू द सब्जेक्ट? दैट इज हर. रितु विल मेक अ केक फॉर हरसेल्फ. सो आई होप चिल्ड्रन यू आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग दीज रिफ्लेक्सिव प्रोनाउन. सो दैट मीन्स those pronouns which are referring back to the subject are known as reflexive pronouns. Now, I am going to give you a chart of reflexive pronouns. You have to see that for what pronouns, what reflexive pronouns are there. Okay, children, I am just rubbing this blackboard. First, some facts that you have to go through reflexive pronoun. First, in reflexive pronoun, in such sentences, subject. And the object of the verb refer to the same person or thing. Okay? In such sentences, the subject and the object of the verb refer to the same person or thing. And the second, descriptive pronouns are formed by adding self to the singular pronouns and selves to the plural pronouns. Okay, so again, I am reading out both. First, in such sentences, the subject and the object of the verb refer to the same person or thing in reflexive pronouns. And second, reflexive pronouns are formed by adding self to the singular pronouns, that is, word self. For singular pronouns, the word self is added after it, and for plural pronouns, we add the word selves. Okay, to the plural pronouns. Okay. Now I am giving you the chart of the singular and plural pronouns that are used. Now singular pronouns. What are the nouns that are coming under the singular pronouns? Like I, for I, it is myself. He, the reflexive pronoun is himself. She, herself. It, itself. And for plural pronouns we have like we, for we it is ourselves. They, themselves. But one pronoun that you have to observe, you. You can use for singular pronouns as well as plural pronouns. If you is referring to a singular subject, then you form will be yourself. In case if it is referring to a singular subject, but if you is referring plural subject, then you will be changing you yourself. Okay. So these are the group of reflexive pronouns, children, that come under the category of singular pronouns and plural pronouns. Okay, children, you can pause this video and you can note down these forms, or already there, they are available in the book. You can get the reference from the book also. Okay, children, the group of reflexive pronouns is completed. Now we'll move to the other kind of group, that is emphasizing pronouns. Emphasizing pronouns. Again, children, what are emphasizing pronouns? A pronoun that is used for the sake of emphasis. Emphasis means putting a stress on the noun that is used for. So, such nouns which are actually used to put a stress on the noun in which place they are used, that such kind of pronouns are known as emphasizing pronouns. First, let's go through the definition of it and then we are proving it through some examples. For the sake of emphasis, that means stress, the vowel, zone designation. Okay? The sake of emphasis are known as emphasizing pronouns. Now let's go through some examples. A lot of you may be confused between reflexive pronouns and emphasizing pronouns, so don't get confused. Go through this concept nicely. Emphasizing pronouns like I, myself, rejected this offer. I is the subject and myself is putting a stress on this subject. I myself rejected this offer. Maine khud is prastav ko aswikar kar liya ya fir skar kar liya. Okay, maine khud, ये जो खुद वर्ड है ये मेरे पर दबाव दे रहा है, इसलिए पुटिंग अ स्ट्रेस ऑन आई मायसेल्फ रिजेक्टेड दिस ऑफर, मैंने खुद इस प्रस्ताव को ठुकरा दिया. और नेक्स्ट he himself finished the project. Himself is putting the stress on the word he now. So this himself word is putting a stress. Like, he himself finished the project. Yani, usne khud se is project ko samapt kiya. So ye khud, ye myself, himself, ye dono jo hai, they are putting stress on these nouns. Okay? They are putting emphasis on these nouns. Okay? So that's why as they are putting a stress on these nouns, that's why they are known as what? Emphasizing pronouns. Now, emphasizing pronouns, to identify emphasizing pronouns, It is quite simple. First, emphasizing pronouns can be used in two positions, which makes them easy to identify. What is the first position? Immediately after the subject. Usually, emphasizing pronouns just come after the subject. So the first position that they can use is what? Immediately after the subject. Right? See this utensils. Ritu herself cleaned the kitchen. Now what is the subject here? Ritu. And you have seen that herself is putting stress on her. And it is just appearing after the subject. Okay? This is the emphasizing pronoun and this is the subject. That Ritu herself cleaned the kitchen. Ritu ne khud se rasoi ghar ko saaf kiya. Khud se. Okay? So Ritu ne kehte khud se rasoi ghar ko saaf kiya. Right. They themselves maintain the school garden. What is the subject here? They themselves. It's putting a stress on they at the subject. They themselves maintain the school garden. Okay? School ke garden ki dekhbhal ve khud karte hain. Ve khud school ke garden ki dekhbhal karte hain. So, this is the position. And you can see that emphasis pronoun just appear after the subject. So, this is the first condition. Either they appear just after the subject, and the second condition. They are either used later in the clause. Okay? Later in the clause. Okay? The first condition we have understood just after the subject, or the second is they can be used later in the clause. Like thank you. Just observe these two sentences. This project will be completed in this year itself. Nothing. Okay. So this project is a subject, will be completed in this year itself. Now this itself word is putting emphasis on project, but instead of just coming after, it has been used at the end of the sentence. Okay? As it is told at the end of the clause. In the second, the students for the subject will finish their preparation by the end of this week themselves. Now this word themselves is putting a stress on the subject, that is the students, but instead of appearing just after subject, it is appearing at the end of the clause. Okay? So this is the second condition in which the emphasizing pronouns can be used. Okay? These are the two conditions. Either just after the subject or at the end of the clause. Okay? So I hope, children, these both examples are clear to you. Okay? Now we will go for the next group, that is distributive pronouns. Okay, before that I am rubbing the green board. Now children, the another kind of pronoun, that is distributive pronouns. Now what are distributive pronouns? Pronouns that show that person or things are taken singly or in separate groups are called distributive pronouns. Okay. The pronouns that show that persons or things are taken singly, that means in singular. Okay, pronouns, distributive pronouns are never in plural form. They represent a group, but they represent each individual of a group. So that's why they are always taken singly or in separate groups. They are known as distributive pronouns. Now, what are the examples of distributive pronouns? Normally, each, either, neither. Okay. So these are some of the distributive pronouns that we use. The examples of the sentences. Each of the student was present. Okay? Okay. You see the word each of the word student, that is referring to every particular individual student. Each of the student was present. Har ek vidyarthi upasthit tha. So har ek, pratyek vidyarthi ke bare mein. Vidyarthi, sabhi vidyarthi ke bare mein individually ko daya gaya hai. Each of the student was present. boys didn't receive any prize, neither. Okay? यानी दोनों में से कोई लड़कों को कोई इनाम नहीं मिला. Okay? Between none of the boys. Neither of the boys means none of the boys. Like each and either they both represent the positive parts of the distributive pronoun because they represent the positive aspect in a sentence, whereas neither represent the negative aspect. Okay? So that's why the sentences framed by neither come under the group of negative sentences, whereas the sentences framed by each and either come under the group of what? Positive sentences. Now, distributive pronouns, one more rule is there that I'm explaining you. Pronouns represent individual nouns or pronouns, so that's why they are always followed by singular verb. Distributive pronouns can never be followed by total verb because they represent singular subject. Okay, so that's why this that you have to always remember. Distributive pronouns. Are always followed by a singular verb. Okay, Simkin? So never use any kind of plural form of verb after a distributive pronoun because distributive pronouns are always followed by a singular verb. So by writing the sentences using distributive pronouns. Make this verbs clear. Okay? This is how comes under the subject verb agreement. If the subject is singular, obviously then the verb followed by it will also be singular. Okay? Now, the other kind of pronoun, the next kind of pronoun that we are going to discuss is reciprocal pronoun. Reciprocal pronouns. By these words, I think lot of them have heard about this word reciprocal. Reciprocal meaning kya? Ulta. Okay? Just repeat. Hey, you have heard this, learned about this word in maths, I think, reciprocal. Okay? The reciprocal pronouns are just representing each one. Okay? We just represent each other. Okay? Pronouns that denote mutual, it's combined, okay? Mutual actions occurring at the same time are called. Two brothers always try to have 1 atom. Okay, the two brothers. Okay, always try to help one another. One another is a group. Okay, so they are just using, subordinating each other. Okay, the two brothers always try to help one another. Okay, so just replicating themselves. Next sentence. Both of the friends looked at each other before leaving. So both of the friends looked at. What is the activity done here? Looked at. So this activity is a combined activity which is done by both of them. As you can see in the definition, the actions, mutual actions. Actually, mutual means the actions which are done by both at the same time. So both the friends are performing this action each other. Okay? Just reciprocating each other. Okay? So both of the friends are just exchanging this action with each other at the same time. So both of the friends looked at each other before leaving. Okay? So you can see this action is performed simultaneously at the same time by each of them. Okay? So such time, these are the examples of personal, sorry, reciprocal pronouns. I hope children the concept of reciprocal pronouns is clear. Just we have to remember this word because there are not too many examples regarding to this pronoun. Okay? So just if you specify this word or remember this word, you can easily identify the reciprocal pronouns. Okay. Now after reciprocal pronouns, the next part, group of pronouns that we are going to discuss is indefinite pronouns. Indefinite pronoun, the definition lies in this word indefinite. Indefinite means kya? Anishchit. Okay? Anishchit मतलब जो किसी एक निश्चित चीज से संबंधित ना हो. सो द डेफिनेशन लाइज इन दिस वर्ड ऑन द इंडेफिनेट प्रोनाउन. सो इंडेफिनेट प्रोनाउन्स आर दोज प्रोनाउन्स in particular are called indefinite pronouns. So indefinite, as I have told, anishchit, jo kisi nishchit vyakti ko sambandhit na. Okay, so they are called indefinite pronouns. So let's go for the examples regarding indefinite pronouns. All, both, on everyone, someone, anybody, nobody, etc. Okay? So these are the pronouns that come under the category of indefinite pronouns. Because you can see that all, both, anyone, everyone. So by using these words, you cannot distinguish any kind of particular person. Okay? They don't refer to any particular person. They don't signify any particular person whenever they are used in a sentence. Okay? So that's why these all words come under the group of what? Indefinite pronouns. Now, regarding to this, like some sentences I am giving to you. Everybody is present here. Has anyone found my purse? There is nobody in the room. So here in the sentence you can see that everybody is present here. Now, everybody is present here, not denoting to any particular person. Everybody means all. Now all of, not denoting to any particular person. Has anyone found my purse? This anyone is a common question that is asked to all of them, not to a particular person. There is nobody in the room. This nobody word is told, not mentioned any particular person, because nobody is a negative word. Okay, nobody means none. Okay, that means nobody is there in the room. Okay, so it is a negative word, whereas these two are the positive aspects in the sentence. So here, the group of words framed regarding to this word, or framed with this word, all come under the group of what? Indefinite pronouns. Okay, children, I hope this is clear to you. Okay, if any problems are there, you can consult me on the Telegram app. And the last group that I am going to mention you after this is what? Relative pronouns. That is complicated and little broad. Okay, so let's go for relative pronouns, which are maximum used in our sentences. Relative pronouns. Now what are relative pronouns? A pronoun that relates a noun that comes before it. To a group of words that follow is called a relative pronoun. Okay? So just like before, reading out the definition once again. A pronoun that relates or refers a noun that comes before, just before it, and relates it to the other group of words that follow it is called a relative pronoun. Just go for the examples, then we will use them in the sentences. Now, what are the relative pronouns that normally we use? Relative pronouns that we normally use are who, whose, whom. Normally, who, whose, whom. They are used for persons only. Okay. Which, that, mostly used for things, related to things, and where, be used for place. Okay, so like that we have relative pronouns of cause like why, we have relative pronouns of time like when. Okay, so these are the relative pronouns that mostly use. So who, whose, whom are mostly referred or related to persons. Okay, which and that are mostly regarded or related to things, whereas where is regarded to place. Okay, now let's go for some sentences regarding to these words. See these examples. Mohan is the boy who stole my book. Now you can see what is the subject here. Mohan. What is the relative pronoun used for him? Is who? And what is the group of words that it relates? Stole my book. Now what is told here? Like Mohan is the boy who stole my book. Yani Mohan hi wo ladka hai जिसने मेरा किताब चुराया है. ओके, सो दिस वर्ड इज रेफर्ड टू मोहन एंड दिस वर्ड कनेक्ट्स मोहन टू दिस एक्टिविटी. ओके, सो दिस वर्ड इज कनेक्टेड बिटवीन मोहन एंड द एक्टिविटी परफॉर्म बाय हिम. ओके, सो लाइक दैट यू कैन सी दैट इज द मैन हुज पर्स हैड बीन स्टोलन. ओके, नाउ हुज इज कनेक्टेड टू सब्जेक्ट दैट मैन. ओके, and what has happened to that man? His purse had been stolen. If we take out this relative pronoun, that is the man, purse had been stolen. There will be no relation between this sentence. Okay? So if we plug out the relative pronoun, the sentence will become meaningless. Okay? So that relative pronoun actually adds the sense to the subject and the object of the verb. Okay? She is the lady whom I met yesterday. Again, the whom, which is regarding the lady. Okay, and this is the spot where the accident happened, meaning to the space where the accident happened. So children, you can see the use of relative pronouns in the referred sentences. Now children, the pronouns regarding to this chapter has been finished. You can go through all the three episodes of this pronouns so that you can understand this whole concept of pronouns very clearly, which has been distributed in three parts. Always keep a reference book with you so that you can carry out the facts regarding your books. Okay, the books will act as a reference for you. Children, just I hope that you have understood this chapter. If you have not understood, you can consult regarding any of the group on my Telegram account. I will try to clarify your doubts. Okay, meet you in the next video. Till then, goodbye.